My name is Jennifer Anora, and I'm a wife, mother, worship leader, and handcrafter. Welcome to my YouTube channel, where I talk about motherhood, faith, DIY, and a little bit of everything. I hope you enjoy today's video. Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, welcome, welcome. Make sure to subscribe and also to turn on the notification bell so you can get notified every time that I put out a new video. So today I'm going to be talking about some helpful tips when it comes to hyperemesis gravidarum. If you haven't watched my video on my experience with that, make sure you watch it. But I do want to preface this video by saying that hyperemesis really doesn't have any cure, but time for most women, because you're pregnant, there isn't much that the doctors can give you to help you with your nausea and vomiting, or there isn't much you can do but to unfortunately wait it out. For a lot of women, it does become better towards the end of the first trimester. It goes away completely, or it lingers a little bit, or for some women, unfortunately, it lasts through the entire pregnancy and sometimes even during postpartum. There really isn't any cure. So these helpful tips that I'm gonna give you are mostly like, you know, things that you could do to help you, not to get rid of the symptoms or whatever, because like I said, that's not possible basically, but tips to just help you through it, if you know what I mean. So yeah, helpful tips through hyperemesis gravidarum. The first tip that I have is that do not allow doctors to dismiss you. Like, do not allow them to tell you that, oh, it's nothing, it's just regular nausea, vomiting, or it's just morning sickness. No, hyperemesis gravidarum is not morning sickness. And a lot of doctors like to dismiss mothers or pregnant women when they come to them with these kind of concerns, and, you know, just like to tell them, oh, it will get better after your first trimester. But it's like, okay, that's not what I want to hear. I need help. Like, I need serious help. And a lot of times, like, if you go to them like in the very beginning, when maybe you haven't like lost a lot of weight or anything like that, you know, they won't really see what it's doing to you. So during those times, a lot of doctors like to dismiss you. And even like, I remember even for me, when I went to the ER, a lot of them looked like they didn't really see the big deal, like, okay, you're here, what's the big deal type of thing. Like, and it was so annoying to see that or to hear that. And it's like, I'm literally like dying, like I can't eat, I can't drink water, I'm literally puking everything inside of me out, and you're telling me, like, you're just being very dismissive. That's just not okay. So don't allow any doctor to dismiss you. If you have to push for something, push for it. Let them know what your symptoms are. Let them know that this is not morning sickness. You need help and you need it ASAP. Okay. The second tip that I have for you guys is to have in your mind to go to the ER or urgent care to get some fluids in your body through IV. Because clearly you can't keep it down by yourself. You won't be able to take a sip. It will come back out. Even things you've not drank will come out. You'll be throwing out bile all the time, and you will get dehydrated very quickly. So don't be afraid to just walk into the ER and tell them, hey, I need fluids. Like, I'm suffering from hyperemesis gravidarum. I can't keep water down. I'm dehydrated and I need fluids. Okay. And then, I mean, they're not going to turn you away. Urgent care is not going to turn you away. They're clearly going to see your skin is suffering from lack of water, because it's going to be very dry. Your lips are going to be super chapped. So they can clearly tell. So just don't fail to walk into the ER or go there. Just get up and go. Don't feel some type of way. Don't think you need a referral from the doctor to go. Just go. It will save you. It will save you a ton. I'm so glad that I did that, because like my second pregnancy, I got so dehydrated that I passed out. And so coming into this third pregnancy, I had that in mind. And so even though I couldn't keep water down, I was like, okay, let me go to the ER, or let me go to the urgent care. Because I remember when I passed out the second pregnancy, I went to the ER, they gave me fluids and it kind of like helped a little bit. But so coming into the third pregnancy, I was like, okay, I am going to go get fluids because I can get it on my own. So yeah, that is my second tip for you guys. The third tip that I have is to not reject help. I know a lot of women want to be superwoman and do everything by themselves and I'm okay and la da 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 da, but no sis, you are not okay. Like, you can't do anything and that's okay. Get all the help that you can get. Your husband is there for a reason, your boyfriend, your fiance, whoever it is, and if they're not, your mom, your best friend, whoever. I mean, I know there's some people that are probably lonely in the world, but to be pregnant, you must have somebody that you can get help from. And if you can't get help from some, you don't have anybody, you're truly lonely, get checked in the hospital. Get checked into the hospital so you can at least be waited on for the whole period of time, because you need the help that you can get. You can't, you know, obviously you can't feed yourself because the smell of food will be horrible. You can't even stand anything. So you will need all the help you can get. Don't reject it. Don't say I can do it all by myself, because you can't. You'll just be sitting there and you just wilt away. Trust me. So don't reject help, especially when it's available to you. The fourth thing that I want to share, or the fourth tip that I want to give, is to not feel bad about certain things. Like, you know, don't feel bad that you're not able to work, or you're not able to clean the house. First of all, those should be the least of your worries. Don't feel bad about anything at all. Don't feel bad about the fact that you haven't taken a shower in 5 days because you just can't get up. You can't do anything. You're weak. You can't even brush your teeth because just having a toothbrush in your mouth is going to cause you to vomit. You can't smell anything, any soap or perfume, nothing. So don't feel bad about that. You're not going to die from smelling, okay? You're not going to die from not brushing your teeth. You're not going to die. I mean, if you're able to just take care of the, you know, the certain areas that you really need to take care of, you know what I mean? Also, your spouse, if you have a spouse, your spouse is there, your significant other is there, let them help you wash it up, let them help you take a shower, take a bath, get you up, get you down, all that stuff. But don't feel bad about it if you're not able to do those things, because honestly, once you get better, you have all the time in the world to get clean, to brush your teeth, to take a shower, all that stuff, get cute and do whatever you wanna do. So don't feel bad about that, because you're only gonna make things worse for yourself. The final tip that I have is to find distractions. I know it's so hard to do anything, but honestly, you can't tell me that you won't be on your phone. Like, I mean, even for me, as bad as it was, like there were, like I was on my phone many times. I did check Instagram, I did check certain things, and honestly, they kind of helped in those like little moments that I wasn't thinking about, you know, my condition. And I remember when I was getting towards the, you know, the finish line, when I was getting a little bit better, I found this game on my phone that I got addicted to. Like, I got hooked to it, and I did not feel bad at all, because it took my mind off of what I was going through. So I was just literally addicted to that game. And prior to that, I think I was binge watching Moesha on Netflix. And you know, you'll get distracted for a while. You won't think about the pain and all. You still feel it, but it kind of helps a little bit, you know, because it's more like a waiting game. You're just laying in bed waiting for the day to be over so you can fall asleep, but you can't fall asleep because it's just so hard to fall asleep. So you might as well find something to do to distract yourself, to pass the time, you know. So that's what I did. I binge watched some shows on Netflix. I played a game that I got addicted to. Even after I felt better, I realized that I had a problem, so I had to like cut it out. But my point is, find distractions to keep you distracted. Yeah, so those are my 5 tips that I have for you guys. I hope that they are helpful. Like I said, honestly, it's a waiting game. There's nothing you can really do to like get rid of the condition other than time and it going away by itself and stuff like that, or having the baby. So just whatever helpful tip that you can take from this that will help you, I hope it helps. Yeah, so this is the end of the video, guys. I hope you guys enjoy it. Make sure to like, share, subscribe, all that good stuff, and I'll catch you guys in my next video. Bye.